This video talks about the Feynman-Koch theorem. For an investment-oriented class, the Feynman-Koch theorem looks frightening. I totally agree. Yet I want to add it as I believe it is crucial for any advanced calculations in the area of pricing and dynamic portfolio management. Hence, I will state the theorem in that video here and provide another video where I apply it to the simplest example to show you how it works. Now, you might already have seen that the conditional expectation operator is a key element in financial economics, whether it's the equilibrium price of an asset or the investor's expected future utility from today's investment and consumption decision. The solution involves usually to get the conditional expectation of some random quantity. Now, the mathematical concept of Feynman and Koch is really useful for such computations. Coming from math and physics, these both math geniuses found that under some regularity conditions, conditional expectations solve a particularly shaped partial differential equation. And at least since Newton, another genius, physicists and applied mathematicians have devoted considerable research time to manage partial differential equations. So for us investors, that implies that some of the harder problems in financial economics can be easier solved if we solve the respective partial differential equation. And it's the Feynman-Koch theorem that tells us what the partial differential equation looks like. So let me first introduce the theorem. Now, treat capital T to be a positive fixed constant. Let f be a continuous function and q also continuous. Now, let x be an Itô diffusion with the following SDE. We also assume that q is lower bounded. Now, a. If the conditional expectation u is given as follows, then for any x element Rn, u is the solution to the following terminal value partial differential equation, where au is the generator of the Itô diffusion u. And it's defined to be the following. Now, b. Moreover, if a function w is continuous differentiable in t and twice differentiable in x, and if that function little w solves the deterministic problem of the PDE that I showed above, then one knows that the little w function also solves the stochastic problem, meaning it solves the conditional expectation. So basically, what the Feynman-Koch theorem says is that if you want to compute a conditional expectation, as denoted here, where x follows an Itô SDE, then you apply, or you can apply, a guess and verify PDE solution strategy. That means you can guess what the solution of the conditional expectation, which we denote as u of xtt cap t, looks like. You plug that guess into the terminal value PDE of the Feynman-Koch theorem, and if the left-hand side of that PDE problem coincides with the right-hand side, then you verified that the guess is correct. In applied math, many of the sophisticated applications work with such a guess and verify method. If you are new to the field, you don't yet see why that is simpler. And after all, where to get the correct guess from? Here again, one borrows insights from hundreds of years of applied math, physics, and engineering research. Now, a more recent, yet very influential paper in financial economics, which in 2002 got published in Econometrica, had been written by Professor Duffy, Professor Singleton, and Professor Pan. Now, in that work, the authors provide correct guesses to problems where q of xt is an affine function in an e to sde for xt, and where also f of xt is an exponential affine function in xt. Now, in a follow-up video, I guide you through the simplest example, namely the Vasicek bond pricing example. If you compare that solution to the alternative of going directly after the conditional expectation, for which I also have a video, you might note right away that the PDE approach of Feynman-Karch is way simpler.